Guys, it has been reported that TGNU has made it to the 100 days, right? 100 days mark. And so we need to look at what the GNU has done so far. Fair, right? Hey, there's another story that I want us to talk about. Host, it appears like EDA has terminated his membership. Let me check here. There's an article released by East Sunday World on the 23rd of September by Uboitumelo Kgopolo. The article says racist Ronaldo House shocked by the termination of his membership. Right? It appears like UETA has terminated the membership of Uhouse, right? And is complaining that there were no reasons that were given. Now, let's move a bit forward here. The DA, people with DA, they were busy protesting because of the mayor that must be removed in Tshwane. There's another story as well that made it to my world, and that story of two husbands win a case to use their wives' surnames. I don't know what to say about this, right? There was a story that was reported by Utina Hokwana, legal practitioner, on the 22nd of September, 2024, who says, according to the story, right? So, two wives together with their husbands challenged the constitutionality of Section 26, Paragraph 1 of the Registration of Birth, Death, and Death Due to Gender Discrimination. Okay, this is going to be interesting. Let's follow up. The first and second applicant were married in 2021, but were unable to register. Were unable to have their husband assume their wife's surnames due to Department of Home Affairs restriction. Their daughters carries surnames they did not intend to be their family name. The third and the fourth applicant, Jess and Donley Bowman and Andrew Bowman, married in 2022, faced similar challenges when they tried to have their husband adopt a hyphenated surname combining both their names. The two couples, it's a bit, when I saw it, I'm like, wow. But the bottom line is that they won the case. The husbands will now be using the surname of the wife. They got what they wanted, and that's the bottom line. They got what they wanted. I'm going to ask you a question. Do you think, as a man, maybe let's start with men. Would you appreciate changing your surname to your wife's surname? And your children are using your wife's surname. But mind you are married. Not just lobolat, married, like legally married, like everything. What will you do? If you are a wife, will you appreciate your husband to use your surname? If yes, why? You don't get to take his surname. He uses your surname. If yes, why? Get into the comment section below. We'll talk about that in the comment section below. We'll continue with that. And I'm going to come back with Uhouse and the 100 days at GNU. But before I can successfully do so, I will highly appreciate if you can do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that,
guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment, so the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, now let's proceed. I want us to start with Ndabaga House. Here, it has been said that Ronaldo House, a former DA MP, expresses shock, shocked at being deprived of both his local parliamentary seat and political membership following 3 months of disciplinary proceeding. House claims that the Party Federal Federal Commission, FLC, was responsible for the length disciplinary hearing and recommended that he stay within the party, assume political parliament duties. Okay? And then in the recording, House can be heard allegedly saying, okay, that word, let's leave that one. And then he came. He said that he received an email from the federal executive informing him of a membership termination. This guy has terminated his membership without providing any reasons due to his disciplinary hearing period. And he claimed the attached demonstrated that the federal has recommended otherwise. My question is, why did we waste 3 months asking actual lawyers to meet and engage with me to find a suitable sanction against me? Then once it is produced, the FedEx, which didn't even sit in any of these meetings, and honestly didn't spend 3 months to go over every single detail, suddenly decided no, and then implemented a harsher sentence. Wow. But now we know that the man is crying and saying, oh, my membership has been terminated by DA. Will you mind? I'm sure you don't. Tell me what you think. 100 days, the GNU. There's an article that was released on the 22nd of September 2024 on Daily Investor Bloomberg. Let's look at the things that the GNU has delivered. Okay. According to here, they are saying that some of the things that the GNU has done was to make sure that there is electricity. And yeah, I'm just going to paraphrase some of the things that I'm seeing here. But yeah, for me, there's nothing significant except to say I have noticed this strategy that these people are using. You see this operation cleanup foreign nationals in big and small places. You know what it does? They are basically creating okay, let me start here. Do you know that the informal sector, it's part of shops alone, in South Africa, they generate around from 175 billion a year to 200 billion a year. Just spaza shops alone in South Africa. And then informal economy, it is somewhere around 750 billion a year, the money that is made in an informal economy. Anything, your spaza shops, your what, anything is considered informal, right? There's more money there. So if you check the stats, about 40% of people who are employed, they are employed through informal economy. So if the government continues to clean up even from the bottom, going upward, you know what they are doing? Simply creating job opportunities. More people will be employed. Because if you go to China Mall, you hardly find South Africans that are working there. You're going to all these restaurants, you hardly, you know what I'm saying? So what if they clean up all those places? Do you see what they're going to do? Create a space for employment for the citizens of this country. So that is something that I've noticed with the GNU, and I'm like, okay, I see what they're doing. I see what they're doing, and I understand why they are doing it. Maybe you've got a different opinion. I would like to hear that in the comment section below. Till we meet again in the next video, please take care.